Yeah, go.
Good afternoon.
This is not.
Thank you.
You are Miss Aishwarya, is it?
Aishwarya.
Aishwarya, okay. Now you are already in the Railway Account Service?
Yes, sir.
You just qualified, is it? Have you joined?
Yes, I am joined. I am currently in my probation period.
Probation
period. In Airfarm, Secunderabad.
Gotcha. You joined the training also?
Yes,
right?
Sir.
Okay. Good. Apuchu.
Why is our constitution so bulky?
Because India is a diverse nation with so much complexities, in order to account for all the necessary requirements, a constitution is bulky. For example, we have so many languages, so many different ethnicities and so much culture. To accord to that and all, and to correct our historical errors, a constitution is bulky, sir.
Okay.
Can you list out some of the provisions which provide for social justice?
Social justice. Yes, sir. The directive principles of a constitution provides for social justice, and it also aims at distribution of wealth, a minimization of inequality and all. And also we have abolition of untouchability. All these articles provide for social equality, sir.
And the provisions for 15 and 16?
Yes, directive principles of state policy and abolition of untouchability. Article 17, sir.
And reservation? 15 and 16?
Yes,
are
sir.
They not instruments of social justice?
Yes, sir. There are many articles for social justice.
No, they are fundamental rights. You talked about
DPSP and also.
Okay. Now you talked about untouchability.
Yes, sir.
What is untouchability in the Indian context?
Yes, sir.
And is the gravity reflected in the constitution also?
Yes, sir. And abolition of untouchability is one of the absolute provision in the constitution of India where there is no compromise at all. So untouchability is not just the literal meaning of not touching a person. It's a wide range of discrimination and discriminatory practices accorded to a section of population, ranging from separate household, separate discriminatory practices in employment and other, all other dimensions of life.
Okay, Civil Caste and Civil Tribe Act, Bastille Act was in news. What happened? The Supreme Court.
Yes, sir. They've been
seized of this matter.
Yes, sir. There have been certain amendments to reduce the intensity of the act, like curbing down the non-bailable provisions and also arresting without any prior sanction. So these amendments were then struck down by Supreme Court, citing that there are still so many crimes committed against the SAST communities, and this necessary safeguard should not be diluted. That's it.
It was struck down, the amendment.
Yes, sir. It's been nullified. The Supreme Court has ordered the government to revert back to the original statute where all the safeguards are still available to them.
The government came back to the original and that has been upheld. Just check.
Okay,
can you tell us about some of the laws, which some of the judgments of the Supreme Court on gender justice?
Gender justice. The famous Vishakha guidelines to protect women against sexual harassment at workplace is one of the.
Is that still applicable, Vishakha guidelines?
Yes, sir. We are following that and the sexual harassment workplace, the she box, everything is following those guidelines, sir.
We have an act now. The guidelines were in place only till there was a vacuum.
Okay, sir.
The judgment itself said that. Any other judgment which brought about gender justice? Some recent judgment.
The Triple Crown also has called for equality among Muslim women, sir. And Sabrimala judgments also pronounced for equality of women, gender justice. All of them is covered under those verdicts, sir.
Thank you,
sir.
Aishwarya, you are from Tamil Nadu, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, sometime ago, the Supreme Court upgraded the Speaker of the Tamil Nadu Legislative Assembly. What was the reason for the Supreme Court's criticism of his actions?
So, it was arbitrary disqualification of MPs without sound rules. I think that was the issue, sir. But I'm not exactly sure, sir.
It was not for any action. It was for non-action.
Okay, sir.
He was sitting on a petition filed by the opposition to take action against defection. But he was just sitting on it. 3 years he sat on the issue. That's why he was criticized by the Supreme Court.
And
to curb that kind of inaction on the part of speakers or unfair action, the Supreme Court also gave some suggestions to the government. Some recommendations were made to decide on these defections under the 10th schedule.
Yes, so already under the 10th schedule we have provisions to decide on what constitutes under defection and what doesn't constitute under defection.
But the Supreme Court suggested an alternative mechanism.
Okay, sir. Flow test, sir?
No.
Sorry, sir, I don't know.
An independent tribunal.
Okay, sir.
They said that an independent tribunal could look into alleged cases of defections and related matters. Anyway, read up on this. As a student of sociology, do you support caste-based reservations?
Yes, sir, I do support caste-based reservations, at least for now, because many sections of the society are at different portions of the ladder. So reservation is a level playing field to provide opportunities for those sections which are historically deprived and which did not have the opportunities which other communities had. So I support caste-based reservation. And once people achieve the necessary level playing field, I think that time we can withdraw the reservation, sir.
Okay. And again on sociology, what is the difference between modernization and westernization? These two concepts.
Sir, modernization is the radical way of thought which is colored by the ideals of liberty, equality and fraternity. It is a change at the ideological level. Whereas westernization is just the outward copying of the standards of the Western society, be it clothing or other practices like food habits and all.
Okay. How would you describe the state of the Indian economy?
Okay, sir. Currently we have this idea of going to $5 trillion economy, but still there are many plaguing issues like unemployment and mainly agrarian crisis, sir. So I think we have to focus on agriculture to increase the employment, and this would make our economic situation much better. And also we are doing very well on the service sector and manufacturing sector also. We are making good progresses in Make in India initiative also.
Any bright spots you can identify?
A lot of sunrise sectors are coming up like food processing industry and startup ecosystem.
I'm alluding to sectors.
Okay,
any bright spots as far as the overall health of the economy is concerned? Some positive indicators, macroeconomic indicators?
So the ease of doing business has improved very well, and also the standard of living has also improved considerably. Literacy rate has also improved, sir, to 69%.
Standard of, that's a debatable question. Improvement in the literacy rate, yes, it's indirectly linked to economic progress, but my question was different.
Okay, sir.
Anyway, we have a very healthy forex reserve. That is one of the positive indicators. The inflation is under control, right?
Okay, sir.
And our trade deficit has also shrunk now because of the this crisis, I mean, the slump in oil prices. That has helped. So these are some of the positive indicators. Last question. Have you been following the developments in UP? Recently there was a High Court order which nullified some action taken by the government of UP in naming and shaming anti-CAA rioters.
Yes, sir.
Right? Then the UP government came to the Supreme Court. What was the decision of the Supreme Court?
Sir, I know the issue till like the naming and shaming should not be done, and it's against the fundamental right to life under Article 21. I'm not sure.
Not to life.
Dignity.
To privacy.
Okay.
Privacy.
Sir. Okay, sir.
And the Supreme Court refused to stay the High Court's order, and it has referred the matter to a larger constitutional bench. But following that, the UP government has come up with something.
Sorry, sir.
No? They are planning to promulgate an ordinance by virtue of which they will recover damages for properties which have been destroyed during the riots.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Aishwarya.
Yes, sir.
You have been staying in Hyderabad for how long?
1.5 months till now, sir.
1.5 months only?
Yes, sir.
Have you seen any of these places of tourist importance?
Not yet, sir. Before that, we were in Baroda, the National Academy of Indian Railways.
Uh-huh.
And currently, we are posted to our CTI, which is...
You have heard about some very important places?
Yes, sir. We have to... Ramoji Film City, I heard about that place, sir.
Uh-huh.
Then, Hussain Sagar Lake is there, sir. I want to visit that one also, sir. Then, Charminar also, sir.
No, Sarajan Museum.
Sarajan.
You have not heard about it?
No, sir.
You know, there is the largest single men's collection in the world.
Okay, sir. Largest.
Okay. Since you are in the railways, the bullet train project is on.
Yes,
sir. Isn't it? Are you aware that some more projects are in the pipeline?
Yes, sir. Like dedicated freight corridor is there in the pipeline?
No. Bullet trains. But the bullet trains will fly.
Okay, sir. Diamond quadrilateral project, sir.
There are certain areas, what I am saying is there are certain areas, certain railway lines between two stations where they are going to introduce similar bullet trains in due course, not right away.
Okay,
first, the bullet train between Ahmedabad and Bombay will be operationalized. Then, meanwhile, this is also on the end, which we are not aware of.
I am not aware about the other routes.
Okay. Are you aware that the bullet train, the ticket costing will be much more than the airfare?
Sorry, sir.
You have no idea. Then no point asking. I thought if you know, then perhaps why should people go by this bullet train rather than going and not go by the flights?
So,
but since you are not aware, no point asking.
But I still can analyze why people should choose bullet trains.
Yes, tell me.
Sir, the convenience in travel in train is much better than airline, sir. Because in airlines, you have to wait in check line for nearly 2 hours. You have to arrive before 2 hours and you have to wait half an hour later. And there is also luggage constraints. But coming to train, those barriers are not there and you can have a peaceful journey overnight. And most of the comfort level, where in economy class we can only sit and we can't stretch our legs. But coming to train, there is a ease and comfort level, where it is much suited for most of the senior citizens and also other sections of people carrying babies and also. So, high-speed rail can also highly benefit the students who wish to commute from one city to another. Students like me can greatly
benefit. Quite expensive.
Sir. Yes, sir.
But quite expensive.
Okay, sir.
It will be cheaper. Traveling by air will be cheaper. Anyway, do you think that the government should not run railways or hotels, and it should be privatized? What do you have to say on this?
Government should run railways, sir, because apart from being a commercial undertaking, railways also has social obligations to cater to the last citizen of India. So I believe government should never wash its hands of railways. But in certain areas where to improve efficiency and to cater to the overflowing demand, I think we can rope in private sector also, sir.
Any other reason as to why the railways should not be privatized?
Mainly social obligations, sir, and also the existing track capacity is very huge, and sudden transfer to private sector would create roadblocks there, and there is also the problem of private sector leaving the larger network in the midway itself. So we can't completely give our railways to private sector, sir.
Has any private sector operator left any of the projects in the recent past midway?
No such recorded case, sir.
You are not aware of?
I am not aware of.
There is Delhi Metro, the airport metro line was with the Anil Ambanis, but halfway through they left because they thought that it is not profitable.
Okay, sir.
Okay, last question.
Yes, sir.
What are the mechanisms in place for fighting corruption in our country? What are the laws? Which are the institutions?
First of all, we have legal measures like Prevention of Corruption Act, and we also have institutional bodies like Central Vigilance Commission and Central Bureau of Investigation.
Any other act apart
to
from
tackle corruption?
Apart from
Prevention of Money Laundering Act.
Yes.
Certain regulations by Companies Act, we have to prevent corruption. And also, we are moving towards more technology and transparency to tackle corruption. I think it is one of the best measures, and which is producing a lot of results in tackling corruption, sir.
Which are the institutions?
Central Vigilance Commission and Central Bureau of Investigation, and also the police and judiciary system, sir.
In the states, is there any such system?
In states, we have a state vigilance commission, sir. Then police and judicial mechanisms, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Right. So, Ms. Aishwarya,
yes, sir.
You have given your first preference as the IAS,
yes, sir.
And second preference is the income tax, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, the government has recently announced an income tax scheme in which they have a kind of an amnesty for income taxpayers. Have you heard of that? Vivad Se Vishwas?
Sorry, sir.
Not heard about it?
Sorry, okay. Sir.
Right. In the Northeast, there have been certain developments. There is a population called the Brus, also the Riangs. Their resettlement has been recently finalized. Have you heard about that? Who are these Brus?
Brus and Riangs are the ethnic tribal population of the state of Assam, sir.
Not of Assam. They were from Mizoram.
Sorry, sir.
Are you aware of how they landed up in Tripura and all?
No, sir.
Are you aware of any insurgency movement in the Northeast?
Yes, sir. The Naga insurgency movement is there.
Okay. So now the Naga insurgency movement, there is the demand for Greater Nagaland, right?
Yes.
What
yes.
is this demand?
Greater Nagaland is the combination of Nagas in different areas. Those different areas also include the population in Myanmar also. And they want to regain their ethnic identity, and all the Nagas of all the different areas, they want to form a particular state and want to name it as Greater Nagaland. But there are issues like we have to coordinate with Myanmar for that. And similar wave of demands would come in.
No, forget Myanmar.
Okay, sir.
Greater Nagaland demands, what are the areas which they are demanding within the country? Which states are affected?
Okay, sir. Sorry, sir.
Yeah, Manipur is affected. Assam is affected. Arunachal Pradesh is affected. These are the neighboring states. So the Greater Nagaland demand is that the Naga population in these areas, that contiguous areas to Nagaland should be merged into one state.
Okay, sir.
Now, Nagaland, the NSC and IM, government had worked out some kind of an agreement with them. But why is the agreement not being finalized? What are they demanding?
Sorry.
No idea. Okay, chali. Okay. Now, you heard of the Right to Information Act?
Yes, sir.
Now, the Supreme Court, recently in a judgment, had something to say on the RTI Act. Can you tell me that?
Maybe regarding the exclusions in the RTI Act, sir?
No, basically it was that they ruled finally that the Office of Chief Justice will also come under the ambit of the RTI Act. Earlier, they were not agreeing to it. So, what is this RTI Act and what is the significance of this Act?
RTI Act is the foundation of good governance. I believe it's a foundation of good governance where all the procedures and the modalities of the government are being conveyed to the public in a very transparent manner, which is indeed a citizen's basic right. But there are certain functionaries who are exempted from RTI Act, and periodically they are also being included under the RTI Act's ambit. But certain functionaries which are of critical security importance, they are excluded from RTI Act.
Yes, certain government departments, intelligence agencies and all. Now, under the RTI Act, can certain information be denied?
Yes, sir. If it is considered to be of critical national security importance, it can be denied, sir.
Yeah, there are 8 sections under Section 8 of the RTI Act, in which under various grounds, information can be denied, right? Now, the RTI Act also talks of a Central Information Commission. What is the role of the CIC?
The role of the CIC is to make sure all the information is diverged, and if there is any appeal against non-divergence of information, the CIC has to step in and require accountability from
them. Yeah, basically, it's an appellate authority.
Yes, sir.
Primarily appellate authority. So, if you are not satisfied with the inputs provided at the lower level, then you go in a second appeal to the Information Commission. Now, what is the difference between a Central Information Commission and the State Information Commission?
I believe State Information Commission is the primary point of contact, and if any central government functionaries are involved, then the appellate authority would be CIC.
Yeah, partly you are right. Basically, the SICs don't come under the CIC. The
okay.
SICs look after the state government departments.
Okay.
And the CIC looks after the central government
okay.
departments. That is the issue, right? Now, have you heard of the collegium system in the Supreme Court?
Yes, sir.
What is the collegium system?
collegium system is the grouping of senior judges in order to decide on the appointments of the judges to be made to High Court and Supreme Court.
How many judges in the Supreme Court comprise the collegium?
The Chief Justice of India and four other senior most judges.
Very correct. Okay. I'll ask you one more question. Supreme Court had recently given a judgment on reservations and promotions. It was an appeal which came from the Uttarakhand High Court. Are you aware of this?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Reservations in promotions for SC and ST candidates, and it is mainly because of their skewed representation at the top levels. So reservation is given, and many raise issues that reservations should be only at the initial level, and after that the discrimination part is mostly over, and reservations in promotions shouldn't be done. But a certain amount of representation is necessary at the promotions.
No, but what did the Supreme Court say? What did the Supreme Court say in this case? Mm-hmm.
It said
that reservation in promotions is not a fundamental right.
Okay.
It's only an enabling clause, right?
Okay.
So now we end your interview.
Thank you.
Give you a feedback, right?
Yes, sir.
How do you think you've done?
Average, sir.
No, you've done well. You already have a class 1 service in your belt. Okay. Now, you see, as you would have faced in your earlier interview, some questions will come from your DAF.
Okay,
and other questions can be from current events. So what we would suggest is, you don't have much time now.
Yes.
Go through the CD which you will be given after this interview. A large number of questions are asked. Just see where you did not have complete information and brush up on those.
Yes,
see? Other thing is that, you know, you have your optional subject as sociology. So you can expect something from there. My colleague asked you certain questions. You belong to Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is your home state. So, you know, what are the issues in the state, what is the general development of the state, what is the human development index of the state, these kind of things.
Okay.
You will certainly be asked as to why from Railway Account Service you want to shift to the IRS, Income Tax and Customs and Excise and all. So, you can always give that would like to. IAS is understanding.
Okay.
But you can say that, you know, this is the highest civil services and it would give me great pleasure to be a member of this contribute. Yeah, that you can say. And in any case, the government gives you an option and you've chosen your preference, right? The railways has also undergone a lot of this reorganization,
yes,
right?
Merger of services
and all. That is also an issue which is, so be aware of that.
Yes,
it is there. Why did the government do this? It was based on a committee's report. Do you think it's a good system? Because, you know, the opponents of the system are saying that, you know, railways has certain technical services and it's not something which generalists can do. So, but in any case, the government has taken a decision. Be aware of the background to that. Now, you have mentioned, you know, you worked in the NSS. What is the significance of NSS? What do you learn out of NSS? You watch West Asian dramas. Asian dramas. So, what kind of plays do you watch? What kind of movies do you watch? Gardening, sketching, table tennis, they can ask you questions. Table tennis will be familiar with, you know, things like which are the international events, what is India standing, who are the top players of India, women and men. That kind of thing you should be aware of. Okay. Otherwise, you're doing very well.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're confident. So, just brush up on current events and a little bit on the budget also, you know, the highlights of the budget. And what's happening around the country. Which paper are you reading?
The Hindu, sir.
The Hindu ke saath ek aur le lijiye na, koi Times of India ya Indian Express ya koi. Because see, Hindu is very good in analysis. But small snippets of information. Donald Trump had come here, a joint statement had been signed. Uspe, what are the highlights there? What did they talk of terrorism in there? See, there is a reference to Pakistan which is made there. Thoda sa isko bhi dekhiye.
Okay, sir.
Otherwise, you're doing well.
Thank you.
All the best.
Thank you. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.